surging. Here's Mangalam with the worldview.
Well, Trump or Biden, while the jury is still out, there is no confusion as far as the market's direction is concerned. Bulls are on top, a near 370-point rally ahead of any sort of clarity coming in on who the next president of the United States would be. But the fact that there is a split Congress based on historical data and how history has gone, split Congress is something that the markets favor. And as a result of which, we are seeing, further gains in U.S. futures as well. Over and above all of that, the Democrat favoring sectors like healthcare, communication services, as well as technology, all of them saw big gains yesterday. Talking about big gains, it was the Nasdaq which saw the biggest gain in many months. So Facebook, 8%, Amazon, Alphabet, Apple, Netflix, wherever you look, big gains coming by in yesterday's trading session. Across the Atlantic as well, the European markets, while keeping an eye out on the rising COVID cases, also watched out for the US elections and big moves out there as well. However, just keep an eye out on a couple of other things. The dollar index has now come off the 94 levels, 93.5, that's where it is. While Brent too has seen a bit of a spike above the $40 per barrel mark. But this is something for another day. Currently, it's a bright shade of green across the Asian screen, as well as the SGX Nifty, which is indicating a start above that 12,050 mark.
Okay. All right. We can take that green with both hands. Thank you very much, Mangalam. And now for something that caused a lot of green in the Indian markets, the State Bank of India numbers came in yesterday. The stock itself rose 4% from its intraday lows. Lower provisions have aided profits for this quarter, but asset quality without the Supreme Court dispensation may be a cause for worry. It has deteriorated. Joining us now is Mr. Dinesh Kumar Khara, Chairman, State Bank of India. Good morning, Mr. Khara, and thank you very much indeed for taking our call this early. I want to start with the asset quality issue. You know, you have guided that counting the restructuring, counting those who have applied and taken moratorium, all that would be 60,000 crore, which is 2.5% of your total book. I mean, is there a danger of it being more? Because the Reserve Bank had guided that for the system, the NPAs could rise to between 12.5 to 14.5. I mean, they expected something like a 4% to 5% increase. You're confident that it will be 2.5 and not more?
Good morning, Lata. First of all, thank you very much for having me on your show. Well, of course, you know, when we have, I must mention that when we have made this assessment, the assessment is essentially a bottom-up assessment when it comes to the corporate accounts. And also, we have been very mindful in terms of our quarterly slippages, the trend which we have witnessed in the past. The other very important factor which I would like to mention is that in the past, we used to have some concerns in the corporate book. But since now we have provided for about 88% as a PCR, so I think we don't have much of a challenge when it comes to legacy. On the top of it, if you really look at it, out of this 14,388 crores, which we have provided as additional performance slippages, we have actually pulled back almost about 6,000 crores. So there's elbow room there also. So considering all these factors, I feel that this guidance which you have given in terms of 6,000 crore likely slippages, that looks like to be which we should be in a position to hold. And also, if I really assess in terms of the stress areas, we could actually pull back in SMEs also in this for this quarter. So I think going forward, it of course involves a little more effort on the part of our teams on the ground to ensure that they are on the top of it when it comes to asset quality. And I think corporate, we feel that since this kind of information which you have gathered, that is a bottom-up, so it should be more based on what people are seeing on ground and with various corporates. So I think overall, I would like to mention that to my assessment, it's a fair assessment, okay. And we have prepared ourselves for that.
Okay. Mr. Khara, good morning. There's quite a bit of pain in the agri book. If you could explain that and
and whether that will increase.
Exactly.
Yeah. If you look at our agri book also, I would like to mention that, you know, agri is a function of where people need to get in touch with the farmer. So this quarter, which we have closed, 30th September quarter, on the ground, there were still challenges of connecting. So our people had to get in touch with the farmers. And of course, because of the COVID, it actually restricted their ability to do so. And what has happened is even in agriculture sector also, out of the 9,000 crore kind of a slippages which are seen there, we have actually pulled back about 1,100 crore in the month of October itself. Mm. So as and when situations have got relaxed a bit, mm. our people could get in touch with the farmers and we could do the review renewals, which actually helped us in ensuring the quality of the loan book.
Okay.
And I think if we really look at it, because if we reduce this 9,000 odd crores, so it was about 7,000 odd crores in the month. On a YOY basis. So I think we are little more than what it was in the Q2 of FY20. Mm. But I think I feel that with the relaxed conditions, perhaps we'll be in a position to improve it further.
Going. Okay. A lot of analysts are expecting that although you'll have guided for 2% credit cost, even Mr. Rajnish Kumar had mentioned that number when he spoke the last time, there could be an upward bias to it. If you want to give it an upward bias, how much higher can it be?
I would like to keep it within 2.
2, okay.
I would not like okay. to give.
All right. Yeah. So I wanted to ask you about recoveries as well. How was it in this quarter? I mean, not that much work could be done. But we understand now that pre-pack resolution is almost ready. That is, you know, you'll do the entire package of how to resolve a loan, just pass it through the NCLT, and in a day it is out, just to vet it. I understand the rules are very close to being finalized. What would your best guess be then in terms of recoveries for the second half?
Well, Lata, when it comes to our total accounts, I mean, total value of accounts which you refer to NCLT is somewhere around 25,000 crore. So, we will have to do a bit of a granular analysis how much of that would actually qualify, because since I don't have the visibility of this pre-pack resolution contours, so unless and until we have the contours, it will be difficult for me to make an assessment that how much will be in a position to recover from there.
Okay.
But nevertheless, we have a situation where one of the steel accounts which is awaiting resolution through NCLT, that is known to all, and I think hopefully it's difficult for me to hazard a guess at this point.
You can make some money on it. Have you pencil?
Okay.
Mr. Khara, a word on the home loan segment, because Kotak has come out with 6.75%. So mm-hmm. you think that will bring some competition, and your thoughts on this space?
I think our product is quite competitive and we are fully aligned to the market realities, and we will also try and see that wherever required, we should be in a position to give tough competition. And despite that, we have got a reach which is across the country, and we are into rural, semi-urban, urban, metro, so all locations. So I think we should be in a position to compete despite whatever has been offered by Kotak.
Okay. I think Anuj's point is, will you be offering a lower product? I mean, will you also come down to 6.75 or even lower?
I think we will evaluate, and then because it's interest is one component, the rest is the package which has to be seen. So we will evaluate that in the overall context.
Okay. What about margins, therefore? 3.34 is much better than several previous quarters. Can it get better?
See, endeavor is there, but our ability to do so will also be the function of what the market compulsions would be. Mm-hmm. So we have to strike a balance in multiple variables. So our endeavor will certainly be there to improve it, but let's see.
No, but then it might slip, you think?
After all, we are all working in the competitive environment,
yes.
And we have to ensure that we have some basic thresholds on which we would like to really run our show.
Okay.
Mr. Khara, one last question, and this is not related to SBI. I wanted your thoughts more as a banker. You know, the last 1 week, 10 days, there's been a lot of chatter about a potential Kotak IndusInd deal. Your thoughts on whether there would be more consolidation in the private banking space?
See, eventually these decisions are guided by various commercial considerations. So I think as far as the private banking space is concerned, For the overall banking, it controls about 30% of the market share. So I think, at the same time, a very small size is also something which is not sustainable in the current kind of a scenario.
Okay.
I think, again, it could be the individual decisions of the management. If at all they feel that there is a merit, they will probably go for it. That's how I look at it. It's actually very specific to the individual situations.
Okay.
And that's all. That's what my viewpoint is.
Okay. So, would there be more OPEX gains? I mean, after the consolidation, one would have thought that you could need fewer branches. Your YONO is going places. Any OPEX gains you can guide?
We serve quite a variety of customer base and across a varied geography.
Yes.
So, for that, we have to have... the phygital is something which our strategy is when it comes to distribution.
I'm not saying you will not have branches. I mean, you will continue to have the largest number of branches, but you can renegotiate rents, take off expensive... would you need an SBT? So, will that, amount to a lot?
Effort would be there. I mean, wherever we are coming up for the renegotiation or the other contacts are due for the renegotiation. So there, all decisions are taken depending upon the obtaining market situation in the respective geographies.
Okay.
So, for such a big balance sheet, whatever we'll be in a position to save, it's difficult to really visualize because it is all, quite a distributed decision making.
Okay.
So, but yes, of course, when it comes to guidance from the corporate office, the guidance is that we should be aligned to the market realities and we should negotiate in such a manner that we should not be shortchanged.
Just one final word. Will you be raising capital? Will you list YONO, SBIMF, anything? Will you be raising capital?
Not in this financial year, because we have, when it comes to capital, we are quite comfortably placed in our CAR. And also, we have recently raised our Tier 1 and Tier 2 bonds at very, very competitive pricing.
Okay.
So, I think for the time being, when it comes to the equity requirement, perhaps our PROVEC will be good enough to support the kind of asset growth which we can visualize in the current financial year.
Okay.
So I think not in the at this point of time, maybe at an opportune time, we will come to market for raising capital.
All right, sir, we will leave it at that. Thank you very much for taking our call this early.